Welcome to Pray With Me, a daily prayer time with Father Alphonse. Let us begin our prayer with the praying of the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In a couple of weeks, we are going to celebrate Christmas, and this day, I would like to lift up my prayers for all children, that they know their life here on earth is very important, and their life is given as a gift to the parents, to this world. And Jesus came to this earth to show us how important life is. What would you like to pray for? Our psalm is 97. The Lord is King. Let earth rejoice. Let all the coastlands be glad. Cloud and darkness are his raiment, his throne justice and right. A fire prepares his path. It burns up his foes on every side. His lightnings light up the world. The earth trembles at the sight. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The skies proclaim his justice. All peoples see his glory. Let those who serve idols be ashamed, those who boast of their worthless gods. All you spirits worship him. Zion hears and is glad. The people of Judah rejoice because of your judgments, O Lord. For you indeed are the Lord, most high above all the earth, exalted far above all spirits. The Lord loves those who hate evil. He guards the souls of his own saints. He sets them free from the wicked. Light shines forth for the just, and joy for the upright of heart. Rejoice, you just, in the Lord. Give glory to his holy name. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The Lord is King. Let earth rejoice. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans, chapter 8, verses 35 to 37. Who will separate us from the love of Christ? Will affliction, or distress, or persecution, or hunger, or nakedness, or peril, or the sword? Yet in all this, we are conquerors through him who has granted us his love. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. My friends, you know what love means. At one moment of your life or the other, you should have felt love for someone. It might be for your parents, your siblings, your friends, your teachers. And then to God, too. Love is something so beautiful. If there is no love, then you are not a full person. There is something lacking in you. And so we need to pray for love. This is what Jesus came to show us. The feast of Christmas is nothing but God's love being shown to us, being given to us in fullness. And so we, in turn, have to love God. We have to love Christ. Otherwise, we will be people who receive all the time and don't give back. Perhaps you can imagine that there are this couple who the spouses between love each other, and that will become a wonderful marriage. But if one person loves the other spouse and the spouse does not return his or her love, then there is not perfect love between each other. There is something that is deficient. The same way, we have to become lovers of God if you want to be holy. Because God loves, and if you don't return our love to God, then we become people of ungratefulness. So now, Paul says, there's nothing that can separate us from the love of Christ. In the midst of affliction, like coronavirus, or distress, or persecution, sword, you know, the threats that people are posing to us because we love Christ, nothing can separate us. Can you and I have the same strength, the same desire, the same love that St. Paul had towards Christ? I am not worried about anything. My first and foremost is to love Christ, because Christ is God. Let us pray. Shed your clear light on our hearts, O Lord, so that walking continually in the way of your commandments, we may never be deceived or misled, that we may always love you, that always love you through Jesus Christ. You are our first and primary focus of our lives. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, Jesus said, and the rest will be given unto you. Lord, help us to love you, seek you first. We also lift up all the children who are born into this world every day and who are growing up like your son was born and grew up in this world. May they feel the importance of their lives, that they may grow up to be citizens of this world and good citizens of this world and the citizens of the eternal kingdom that is prepared for them with you. In the precious name of Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ. Thank you for joining me in this prayer. If you are blessed by this time of prayer, please click on the like, share, or subscribe button and share with others. May God bless you.